stacking treasure banks can't measure. CSB production. What's going on, YouTube? Long time. First off, I wanted to thank my subscribers for staying subscribed. It's been a while since I made a video. Life happens. And all these new subscribers who keep subscribing, that's awesome. Thank you. I guess some of you like my videos, so that's cool. So anyways, all you guys know, I do a pickup once a month, basically. So went to the coin store. Winsor is somewhere new because the Troy Ounce is closed on Saturdays. So I tried this place out that's been in business for 6 years and actually was a little disappointed. I went in, they have a big selection, but 10 ounce of sunshine bars they were selling for $2.65 a bar. So I questioned the guy and he was telling me like bullion guys make no money. They have to buy 500 bars at $2 over spot, so that's why they're charging so much. Well, we all know you can buy them for less than $2 over spot, and you definitely don't have to buy 500. I know if I go to Isaac, I can get them $1.80 over spot or something like that. So I was a little turned off, but, you know, when your account gets high, your bank account, you know, I always try to spend the money before the wife sees it and she starts spending money. But knock on wood, my wife's good. She's on the same page as me and not high maintenance and doesn't spend much money, but still, you know, you're a little more tempted to spend more money when you have a lot of extra money in your account. So I always try to get rid of it. So anyways, this is what I picked up. So I got three Philharmonics. They were 26 bucks an ounce. Remember, I'm Canadian, so spots, I think, around 23 an ounce. So I actually said to the guy, oh, I'll buy all Philharmonics because they're cheaper than your 10-ounce bars. So you don't see these too much on YouTube. But yeah, they're actually really nice coins, and I actually really enjoy the non-reeded edges. It's definitely a cool look. So yeah, if you haven't seen them, you know, the instruments in the front, and then the wiener or something. I forget what they call this thing. But yeah, it's on the back. So nice coins, and then I bought a quarter ounce of gold, and obviously I overpaid because this place was expensive. I paid $4.25 for the quarter ounce of gold, and I know that's more than what I should pay, but I figured I might as well buy this versus buying these 10 ounce bars and paying a huge premium. I would have got more of the Philharmonics, but you didn't have that many, so. But yeah, I dropped 500 bucks. I'm trying to spend 500 bucks a month on metals, so bam, 500 bucks. So yeah, that's what I picked up this month. You know, sometimes you get that silver itch and you get that itch that even preparation H can't fix. So, you know, I'll go to Silvertown and get one of their free shipping coins. So just like every other YouTuber, I got the croc. Actually, from Silvertown, it's basically in perfect shape. I've seen some of yours where they're just so beat up and, you know, that's because of the tubes, right? But this one's in really good shape and I'm really happy with it. So yeah, that's what I picked up this month, 4 ounce silver, quarter ounce of gold. So yeah, I'm going to definitely do more videos, guys. I'm actually thinking about doing like a common sense video, you know, something like Josh Galt's Millionaire Series, but from an average person's perspective. You know, I'm a landscaper, I'm not making a killing, but I'll give you an example. When I started reading about money and I started learning about money, and we did our net worth, we were minus $7,000. We were worth less, you know, like not worth anything, you know, to date right now. So what, three and a half years later, if not less, we're now worth, and I, you know, it's just throwing a number just to show anyone can do this, guys, anyone. We're now worth $126,000 in 3 years. I've increased it $132,000. So I'm thinking about doing a series just to say what you should do. The biggest thing I think is a net worth. You do that every month. You see the gains, and it keeps you humble and motivated. Now there's no question in my head, you know, we'll be millionaires, and I used to never think we would. But anyone can. So I'm thinking of doing a series, you know, if you guys think it would be cool. You know, I don't mean to bust up Josh Gall. I think his series was awesome, and I love watching any of those things, you know, and reading about money or, You know, I'm reading the Wealthy Barber again. I've already read it twice. I've read the new one. I love reading about money because, you know, you always learn or you get sidetracked. So if you guys want to see it, maybe I'll start making a series. But yeah, that's my pickups for this month. So still stacking. And yeah. All right, cheers, guys.